Model sheets for cartooning and animation. Model sheets serve as the blueprint for your character so that you can draw the character consistently. They usually have a front, three-quarter, and profile view, but they can have other views included, like if you're going to see the character from back or back three-quarter. First thing you want to do is start off with a couple of concept sketches. Be real simple with these things. Just think line of action, egg bell bowl, bone points. Don't get too caught up on details because you want to get the pose right. The pose should say something about the character. This pose spoke to me because it gave the character a real nonchalant feel, and I traced the pose onto one of the 7x17 sheets of paper, and then I drew guidelines at the top of the head and the bottom of the head and key points along the figure so that I could keep things steady and consistent. You want to make sure that all your guidelines are parallel to the top of the paper and parallel to each other, otherwise everything looks wonky. Starting at the top of the figure, put guidelines at all the major bone points, like the elbow, all the major shapes, like where the torso meets the hips, bottom of the hips, knee, and down to the foot of the paper. Make sure you use a center line to orient your pose. It tells you which way the character is facing. So three-quarter in front, use the center line. You don't need one for the profile. One of the cool challenges of the character model sheet is to see how the figure changes from the different views. So like the belly was really important from the three-quarter view, and I don't want to lose that when I go to the front view. I want to get a little hint of it, but it's not going to be the same because we're seeing the sides of the hips. And on the profile view, we definitely want to see that belly. So the figure changes through the view. One of the things you're really going to need to watch for is the idea of foreshortening when you're turning the character. So for instance, the distance from the shoulder to the elbow, as the character turns toward you, that elbow is going to move closer to the shoulder, and that's a hard call to make, so be very careful with the foreshortening. Once you've got the skeletal understructure, the fun part can start and you can skin the character out. Really think about how fleshy the character is. You're stretching skin over muscle that's kind of stretched over bone, so let the structure guide you. Put nipples and a belly button on your character when you're working it out too, just to reinforce that orientation of the character. The center line is good, but things like a nose, nipples, and belly button will really keep it pointed in the right direction. After your character is skinned, then it's time for the costuming, and the costuming is really fun. You get to just let your imagination go wild. I like to think about layers when I do costuming, having something on over something else, so that you can add layers of meaning to the character. Costuming is also a great time to bring into your research idea. I know how to draw a suit, I know what disco suits look like, but I think a little picture here, there were some details that my imagination would have omitted if I would not have had the little photographic, the primary resource there. When it comes to inking your piece, you want to use at least four different kinds of lines. You want to have bold lines, like this, fine lines in there, like that's a pretty fine line. You want to have weighted lines, really bring your character to life, like this idea going from thin to thick, back to thin again, and then these little broken lines in here. It gives your character a lot of life to have those lines. Okay, finishing up. Remember, you want to start with your basic poses, just line of action, egg bell bowl, do the rotation. When you're satisfied with the rotation, skin the character out, make sure that everything's working well, practice dressing the character up a little bit, have some fun with that, practice inking, and then when you've done all the practicing that you need to do, put the inked paper on the final piece. Include the basics, the front pose, the three-quarter pose, and the profile pose. But you can add some extras in here. I did a little bit with the head rotations, I did a little bit with expressions, I did a little bit with the body, and probably most important, I did a little bit of writing in there, did some annotating that would help to tell the story so that somebody else who was going to draw this guy could get a feel for the character.